might be wondering who these two Jungle Boys are. This is Jai and Flynn. They are brothers who grew up on the Cocos Islands. In December 2019, a group of creative fellows were to visit them on these islands for an adventure of a lifetime.
This is the Cocos Islands, a series of 27 islands in the Indian Ocean. And what's crazy about these islands is that they're actually a part of Australia. Unreal beaches all to yourself, with the most crystal clear water you've ever seen, and deep jungles filled with thousands of coconuts. I honestly didn't think places like this existed. Back in December last year, I was lucky enough to experience true island life with a bunch of amazing people. It went something like this. Our first day consisted mainly of surfing and exploring nearby beaches. Most of the time, you'd only have to share the water with about 2 or 3 people. Cocos Islands has a population of about 600, but West Island, which is where we were staying, has a population of about 180.
It actually smells hell delicious.
Yeah, it's like, you can eat this if you want.
One of my favourite things about this trip is that we had no internet or distractions. It was super refreshing and allowed us to enjoy it a lot more. We ended our first day with sunset drinks while watching reef sharks in the shallows.
But did you get the shot?
The next day, we jumped on a $2 ferry and headed over to Direction Island.
I can feel the camera there.
No joke, that's the bluest water your eyes will ever see. After a day of exploring this tropical island, we were told of a shipwreck not far offshore. We had to check it out.
Yeah, caught on fire over near Direction Island and then drifted in here and sunk here.
Prison Island, a place you'd only think existed in movies.
So we're heading off, we're going camping on a secret island. Can't tell you too much, but it's going to be full of coconuts.
It's a secret.
Coconuts and rum.
So there we were, heading off to camp on an island all to ourselves. A once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Oh, hello, how you going? Well, welcome to, I don't know what this island's called, but we're on that island, camping here in Cocos. I'm gonna show you around. Come this way, okay? 5-star accommodation. Tom there, just walking past. A couple of swags. Got all the crew running around.
Oh yeah.
crew's collected up some firewood. Very, very important, you see. Once this fire's gone at night, that's when we go a little bit crazy.
Yes.
But over here, we've got makeshift bar. So we'll be serving cocktails, beers, everything all night.
This is the wrong ask.
Okay, there's no beers in that one, but.
What can I do for you, mate?
Great Norm, thanks, mate. Extra cold. Thanks. This is what they call island living, mate.
We're here for months. We ain't going anywhere.
After an insane camping experience, we travelled back to West Island and met some of the locals. West Island is also full of crazy jungles that we were dying to explore. So we got on our bikes and rode off into the unknown. The Cocos Islands might seem like the most pristine place in the world, but even in an untouched paradise like this, you'll find beaches full of plastic. Majority of it had drifted from overseas countries, not from the locals.
Absolutely deadly. They never die. These things, they stay like this forever.
We spent our morning cleaning up as much as we could, filling dozens of bags. For our final day, we had a motorised canoe tour planned for sunrise.
So we've embarked on a journey on these canoe tours, motorised canoe tours, in this beautiful island, and we're going to South Island. Welcome to my canoe tour.
It's fine, okay, now I'm getting all good stuff.
I don't work with times, I work with tides.
Don't go with times, my life. Shut up. Don't go with times, go with the tides.
I think we got a winner. This guy's gonna win the Cocos Olympics.
Races to the first circle.
We got
still tickets are racing! Yeah, we get.
Come on. So unfortunately I didn't win the Cocos Olympics this time. But hey, there's always next year. We ended off the trip with one last sunset. Everyone was dressed in white to celebrate the countless memories we had created.
Can I get a yeah, baby?
Being so disconnected from the outside world, we became so much more connected with the people around us and the environment that we were in. And that was something worth celebrating. This was truly an adventure of a lifetime, one that we'll never forget.
Dude, you still have that coconut that I threw at you. You have it on the screen. I don't know if that's clean.
Just blurred it up. You
come here, come here, baby.
Oh, with your spaghetti clothes.
Yeah.